The upcoming fourth season of hit show Stranger Things is slated to air next year, and star of the show, Millie Bobby Brown, might have just given us a hint as to who the writers will be killing off on the show this season. Today, we're discussing everything we know so far about season 4, plus the news that Millie Bobby Brown has given a major death flag to one particular character, so stay tuned. First up, when can we expect to see the show? As of right now, we don't have a specific date for the season 4 premiere, but we know it will be somewhere in the middle of 2022, which means a summer release for our favorite gang from Hawkins. The episode titles have been released, however, and we know that the first episode will be called The Hellfire Club. As we mentioned, the fourth season should be with us in July or August of next year, and it will be interesting to see where the first episode picks up after all of the mayhem from the season 3 finale. What do you want to see addressed in episode 1? Let us know below. So, who can we expect to depart in season 4? Let's see. So as fans become more and more excited about the upcoming season, it has been revealed that this season will be the scariest so far, which means we can more than likely expect some grisly deaths. But who is going to bite the dust? That part is not so clear. What we do know for sure is that after season 3's finale, Hopper is not dead after all. On the contrary, he is jailed in the frozen wasteland of Kamchatka, Russia, where, according to the synopsis provided to us by the Duffer brothers, he will face dangers, both human and other. It's all looking pretty grim for our favorite sheriff. We hope he gets back to Indiana safe and sound. Millie recently hinted that someone big on the cast will be leaving us in the new season, but wasn't giving much away. Do we think it might be Hopper? He's already proven that he's willing to sacrifice himself, so we'd say the chances of him finally getting the proverbial bullet might be pretty high. Who do you think it should be? Who else could be facing the chopping block then? Let's discuss, starting with Mike. We don't really have anything against Mike, but he's a bit, how do we say, meh, don't you think? He's obviously a key component to the group, and the common belief for the show's fans is probably that all the kids on the show are safe. But with our understanding being that this season will be much darker, could that mean one of the kids is set to be killed off? True, Mike is the group's fearless de facto leader, but sometimes he comes across a bit too caring and trustworthy, if that makes sense. Nobody is that nice. Or are we being cynical? Mike's relationship with Eleven has gone from strength to strength over the whole series, which we believe might be the catalyst for a Mike-shaped twist at the end of season 4. He is continually in danger, as he is always so close to Eleven, not just physically but emotionally too. We think there is a pretty solid chance the powers that be will believe they have to kill off a main character in the final season of Stranger Things, and what better way to provoke Eleven than to take Mike away? What do you think the chances are of Mike being killed off in season 4? Let us know below. Next up, let's talk about Nancy. Played by Natalie Dyer, Nancy is one of the characters on Stranger Things to show real development over the first 3 seasons. She started off as the stereotypical, materialistic teenage girl obsessed with boys, but has to check her priorities after what happened to Barbara in season 1. We see her blossom into an intelligent young woman who becomes a core cast member. Nancy is Mike's sister, and just by her family ties, it means she is never far from danger. It has been rumored that Nancy might be the one to go, saving Mike from some new threat. Nancy's death would obviously impact the whole crew and have knock-on effects on the Byers family too, as well as the whole town. What odds do you give Nancy of being the one killed off? Let us know below. How about Jonathan? Stay tuned and we will discuss next. Jonathan has gathered quite the cult following online. A sort of social outcast, he comes across as reserved, and it doesn't help his case that he seems to be a bully magnet. Especially in season 1, he keeps himself to himself, but begins to flourish as we delve deeper into the show, and by the end of season 3 is something of an anti-hero, stopping at nothing to protect his family and those that he cares about. Many people believe Jonathan's status as not quite a core member of the group means he might be deemed expendable. But that is not to say fans wouldn't be sad. His perceived status has many fans convinced that his journey is coming to an end, as if he was the one to be killed off. There wouldn't be as much uproar as there would be if one of the core kids died, but what would Jonathan's potential death mean for Joyce and Will? What do you think about Jonathan being the one to die? Steve is up next. Steve is probably the one character that has faced more speculation than any other character regarding his future fate. From the very outset of the show, fans were longing for his demise, as he came across as a bit of a tool. Sorry, Steve. He soon came around, though, and dropped his tough guy persona, and also stopped harassing Jonathan. Steve's death would probably come in some grand gesture of heroism, more than likely saving one of the kids, or maybe even Nancy, from harm's way. Steve has the biggest 180 of any character on the show, and due to his multiple acts of fearlessness, he is now regarded as one of the most beloved characters. Quite the turnaround, Steve. A lot of fans see the only reasonable way to close Steve's arc would be with his death, which we can understand, but he doesn't have to die, guys. Where do you stand in relation to seeing Steve killed off? Let us know below. No death list would be complete without 11, right? Stay tuned. Was Millie purposely staying quiet because she knew it was her character that would be killed off? Obviously, the whole premise of the show revolves around her, but would the writers actually risk the backlash that they would inevitably receive should they write the star of the show out? We don't think they're brave enough, to be honest. Eleven has repeatedly shown her mental fortitude throughout the whole series, undergoing some horrible trauma after being kidnapped and used as a test subject, but we just cannot see the show going on without her. Who would come to the rescue of her friends if there is no one with special powers on hand to bail them out every time they're in a sticky situation? However, as one theory we saw pointed out, she has lost her powers at the end of season 3. So, theoretically, it wouldn't make much of a difference if it was Eleven who was killed off. She is now as susceptible to the same dangers as the rest of the crew is, but we still think it would be a stretch for them to kill off our hero, even with the publicity that would inevitably come with it. So, what do we know about the fifth season? Stick around. There is no concrete news just as yet to whether or not the hit show will return for a fifth season, but showrunners Matt and Ross Duffer have had their say. The brothers who write the show were recently asked if season 4 would be the last. Ross replied, "Season 4 won't be the end. We know what the end is, and we know when it is. The pandemic has given us some time to look ahead, figure out what is best for the show. Starting to fill that out gives us a better idea of how long we need to tell that story." Well, that's good news, right? Where would you like to see the show go if we do get a fifth season? Let us know below. And finally, we're looking at a few of the new characters for season 4. So as we know, our core group will be remaining, but there will be a ton of new faces in the fourth season. There will be 3 new regulars: Jamie Campbell Bauer, of Fantastic Beasts fame, Eduardo Franco, who appeared in Booksmart, and Joseph Quinn, who turned out in Game of Thrones as Conor. Loads more recurring characters have been added to the lineup as the story moves out of Hawkins for the first time. One of the biggest additions is Freddy Krueger actor himself, Robert Eglund, who will surely ratchet the scary up to 11 should he be anything like his former character. Also making an appearance will be Tom Walashida, Sherman Augustus, Nicola Jericho, and Mason Dye. Who are you most looking forward to seeing? Let us know below. As always, thanks for tuning in today, and remember to join us next time. Why not pass this video along to your Stranger Things fan friends? Bye, guys.